Good morning, class. I welcome you all to your grammar class. Dear students, we have started the lesson verbs in the previous video. I hope the portion I have taught you in that video is clear to you. Now, this is the second video and I'll be explaining you about transitive and intransitive verb and few more things. Firstly, what we have to keep in mind, what is the difference between transitive and intransitive verbs? So let's see the definition on the board. This is verbs, the chapter is verbs, lesson number 7. Here we are going to talk about transitive verbs. What do we understand about transitive verbs? In very simple words, if I don't read the definition for you, before reading that I will tell you. If you need or require an object to complete your sentence, then you can say your sentence is in transitive verb, is of transitive verb. So here the definition says a verb which requires an object. Requires an object means it needs an object to complete its sense is called transitive verb. If your sentence requires object, without object, if your sentence is not complete, if the sense of the sentence is not okay, it is not clear to you, then it means you want some object to be added to the sentence so that you can easily make out what type of sentence is. If you will find object in the sentence, that means it is transitive verb. Children, we have two examples which I have written for you on the board already. I will be explaining with the help of these how you can find object in the transitive verbs. The chief minister made an appeal. In the previous video I have also explained you about objects. We have two kinds of objects I have told you. For finding out the transitive verb, we will find the direct object. We will not look for indirect object but only direct object. And for direct object we will ask the question what. Okay, let's see. In this, if I ask you what is the verb here, this is your verb, am I right? Then we will ask the question, the chief minister made an appeal. What did the chief minister make? The question, when you will ask what, then you will get what chief minister made an appeal. So this an appeal is your object of the verb. Is it clear to you? Because this is your verb and if I remove this portion, if I read the chief minister made, what do you will think? What he made? What is the sense of the sentence? The sense won't be complete until and unless I will add some object to it. When I have added an appeal, then you have understood, oh, this is what the prime minister did. And he made an appeal means this is when you will ask the question what. When you will ask the question what, then you will get the answer an appeal. This I was talking about the first example. Let's come to the second example. It says we read our books. Read. This is your verb. And if I ask a question what, if I ask the question what, yeah, then what will be the answer? We read what? We read our books. So books is your object. Books is your object. I think with the help of these two examples I have made it clear to you. Transitive verb you can understand in this way also, that in transitive verb you can see that verb is transferring. The verb, this verb is transferring that an action upon the object, on something. Can you see? Reading what? Reading book. So we can see that transferring of the action here made what? Means the verb is asking what. Then your verb is, means your verb is transferring an action upon an object. This is all about your transitive verbs. When you will turn your page, see page 45, in that we have a description of intransitive verbs. Remember children, your sentence is not complete or it has no sense until and unless you have object in it, in the case of transitive verb. But intransitive verb says, here it is definition of intransitive verbs. Some verbs are complete. Some verbs are complete in itself. In itself. It means some verbs which are complete in itself, they don't require any other word to add, to be added to it. They do not require an object to complete the sense. In the transitive, we required object to complete the sense. But here in the intransitive verbs, it says we do not need any sort of object to complete its sense. It is complete in itself. That verb is itself complete. When you will read it, you will find that yes, it is complete. We do not require any other object or anything else to be added to it. Such verbs are called transitive verbs. These kind of verbs where there is no requirement of object and they are complete in itself, they are known as intransitive verbs. Intransitive verb is one that does not act on anything, okay, or you can say does not act on something. Like verb was acting on the object, we had seen this in the case of transitive verb. But in the examples of intransitive verb, I will show you that there is no requirement of the object or no transferring of the action on any object. Let's see, we have some examples in the book. You can see your book. Example 1. Maya sat down. Maya sat down. This sentence is complete. It is not making us puzzled that what. Like in this case, when we were reading, the chief minister made, then we were thinking of the question, what he made. But here, we are not coming out with any sort of question. Maya sat down. It is simple as that, Maya sat down. So, do you think we need to add any object here? No. It looks complete in itself. Sat is your verb here. Sat is your verb. And it is showing you that this verb is not transferring any action on any other word or object. Transitive, intransitive verbs do not pass the action to the object. In a simple word, you can understand in this way. If I give you one example from my side, snow fell yesterday. Snow fell yesterday. Fell is your verb. It is not transferring. It is not transferring the action. No object is found. Or we don't feel any requirement of the object where we can transfer the action. So, in this manner, this sentence also explains you that we do not require object in intransitive verbs like we required in transitive verbs. I hope the difference between transitive verbs and intransitive verb is clear to you. Now, here in the book it says some verbs can be used both. Both means as transitive and also in intransitive verbs. They can be used in both the forms. Here I have one example to differentiate this. When you will read this sentence, you will see these plants grow fast. We will read this one too. We grow roses in our garden. What is the common word which you can find in these two sentences? It is a verb. This is a verb and this is common. But let me tell you, these two sentences are indicating you that one of them is an example of transitive verb and one of it is an example of intransitive verb. What you have to see, if the verb is transferring the action to the object, then you will call it as transitive verb. But if there is no object to which the action is transferred, then you will understand it that is not your transitive, that is intransitive. These plants grow fast. If you ask the question what, will you get any answer here? Or do you think any object is there for the verb to transfer the action? No. No, there is no action. Or no action which is transferred anywhere. So what type of sentence this will be? This is type of intransitive verb. And see this, he grows roses in our garden. Now children, grows is your verb and let's see if it is transferring the action somewhere. Is it transferring? Can you ask the question what and can you find the object here? We grow roses in our garden. You will find when you will ask question, you will get, if I ask what we grow in the garden, then we will get the answer that we grow roses in the garden. And this is what your object. So when you have found the object here, that means you can say this is your transitive verb. So by this you have understood that same verbs, some verbs can be used, means some verbs are same, okay, like grow and grow. This word grow can be used for both the purpose, for transitive verbs also and for intransitive verbs also. Only you have to find out whether they are transferring the action to some object or not. If I tell you one more example from my side, hear carefully everybody. He runs along the beach every morning. He runs. I have taken the verb here runs. Okay. And I have second example also. He runs a small grocery store. When I am talking about he runs a small grocery store, when you will ask question, what does he run? Then you will get he runs a small grocery shop. Means what he runs? He runs a small grocery shop. The grocery shop, this grocery shop will be your object. So, verb is same, runs. And you have got the object. In the first example which I read for you, it was he runs along the beach every morning. He runs along the beach every morning. Any object can you find? any question, if you were asked, will you get the answer of what here? No. So this is what we have, similar verbs which can be used in both the cases. I hope, children, I have made these 2-3 points clear to you. I want you all to revise them, to understand them in a better and in a good way. So keep on revising this chapter. We will further proceed in our next video. Thank you and take care.